Moving on, CBI is conducting searches at multiple locations across Mumbai in connection with the Yes Bank money laundering case. Raids were conducted at 7 locations a day after CBI registered case against the founder and CEO of the bank, Rana Kapoor. Case has also been registered against Divan Housing Finance Limited, its promoter Kapil Wadhwan, and Duat Urban Ventures India Limited. Case has been registered on the charges of criminal conspiracy, cheating and corruption under relevant sections of Indian Penal Code and Prevention of Corruption Act. CBI has alleged that Rana Kapoor extended financial assistance to DHFL to get substantial undue benefits in return for himself and his family members via companies held by Kapoor and his family. FIR was registered after agency's specialized unit dealing with bank fraud cases examined the matter. In CBI's FIR, Yes Bank's co-founder Rana Kapoor, his wife Bindu and 3 daughters have been named as accused. DHFL's promoter Kapil and Dheeraj Wadhwan also make into the FIR as accused in the FIR. And my colleague Yogesh Sheetal is joining us from Mumbai with more updates. Yogesh, what is the latest that you can share with us as far as the investigation on the case is concerned?
In Delhi, in this case. So now there are 2 agencies involved, and what we are getting from the sources that income tax also stepped in the probe. So there are 3 agencies right now which are investigating this this matter. As far as Rana Kapoor is concerned, currently he is under custody of the Enforcement Directorate, and he is expected to be confronted with other suspects also in this case. As ED argued yesterday in the court that Rana Kapoor custody is required because other suspects, not only from Yes Bank officials but also other officials from different companies, one of the companies and I think number of companies which are directed by Roshni Kapoor and also Radha Kapoor, and also there are 3 daughters and also Bindu Kapoor. So there are multiple companies that are run by the company in different on different positions. So when he'll be produced again after the custody of Rana Kapoor ends. On the other hand, if we just talk about precisely the CBI, what CBI has done, CBI has registered separate case under 120B, that is the criminal conspiracy, and also cheating is there, Prevention of Corruption Act PCA is there. So there are multiple charges that are labeled against Rana Kapoor, and it remains to be seen that how this works in the court. But definitely at this point of time it can be said that the investigation will go long, and there are very complex investigation because multiple agencies have stepped in, and there are many things that are still to be come out in the time to come.
Yogesh, also just to simplify the case a little, does the money laundering charge that Rana Kapoor and his family are facing, does that lie at the heart of the Yes Bank crash that we witnessed in the days earlier?
This is one of the key reasons. This is one of the key reasons. Money laundering charges is one of the key reasons. Apart from that, there are other charges like insider trading cases also involved. And ED has also deposed in the court. ED had also said in the court when yesterday the agency was arguing that the money that was laundered were used for personal purpose of by Rana Kapoor. So there are multiple things. But yes, you have rightly said that this is one of the key reasons that why the entire thing surfaced.
And Yogesh, among these investigations, what about the concerned depositors whose hard-earned money is there in Yes Bank? What kind of advisory, what kind of assurance? We've seen Finance Minister earlier saying that the money is safe, but what is the latest on the advisory for the depositors of Yes Bank?
Not only finance minister, but also SBI has said, and also many financial experts has said, even RBI's former ED Usha Thorat has also said that there's no need to worry for the depositors at this point in time. It's a hard time for depositors. They are facing some tough situations, but some relief is also being provided. Like earlier, the ATMs were supposed to be used by the Yes Bank ATM only, but now they can use that ATM to other ATMs, they can use the ATM card to withdraw money from other ATMs also. So some relief, sort of relief has been provided, but exactly there is no clear advisory about what would happen to the EMI accounts. So it is expected that in some days of there could be some kind of relaxation that given to the depositors, but as of now all of them have said that there's no need to worry for the depositors. This is just a small time of moratorium, that is a very small process that had also happened in the earlier also.
Okay.
So there's no need to worry, that assured by the not only by the RBI also. Yeah.
Right, Yogesh, thanks very much for joining us with those inputs from Mumbai.